see me on the vibe, yeah, I know you know. Try to catch me slipping, but you know I won't. I got covering, watching every move. Never see me give up, now I'm in a no growth. Yeah, 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 in a no growth. Yeah, 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 in a no growth. Yeah, 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 in a no growth. Yeah, I'm in a no growth.
Hey, everybody, how you doing? This is your favorite girl next door, and I have a wonderful guest. I'm super excited to have her on the show, Miss Simone Slater. Everybody give her a round of applause.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much for coming on the show, girl.
I am honored to be here. I'm ready to seize the day. I cannot wait.
So, Simone, just tell me like some background to yourself. I know you're a graduate of Howard University. I'm planning to get my master's there. So, like, I'm super excited. I was like, oh, she's a Howard alum. Yes. So.
Yes, I will give you all tea on things of Howard.
Yes,
but I'm originally from San Diego, more specifically Oceanside, California. And then I just wanted to be around more diversity. So then I went to Howard University. And then post-grad, I wanted to be in a place where I could see something different and thrive. So then I moved to Dallas, Texas, and now I teach kindergarten here. And this is my second year teaching kindergarten, and I love it. It's not for everybody, just like everyone can't teach older kids, some people can't teach younger kids, but kindergarten is my jam, and I love it. Love my kids, love my school.
Oh, that's awesome. And you can see it in your videos. You can tell that you really, truly love what you do, and that makes a difference. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, like,
that makes a difference. They always say, like, if you love what you do, you'll never work a day in your life. So
exactly. I think it's a blessing to be able to find something that you enjoy and that you can also make money from. Like, I can support myself through something that I love to do. Now, every day is not like, you know, sunshine, rainbows, and a grand time.
Right.
But most of the time, I just love being with my kids, and that they energize me. And I just pray that I give them something in return too.
So did you know, like, young Simone, did you know that you always wanted to be a teacher?
Girl, I did. And my mom has just recently sent me a picture she found in our picture closet. And I was in kindergarten, and we had a costume parade in Halloween. And I was a teacher, and I had a little folder that says Miss Slater on it. I had a little glasses she gave me. So I think just how much I love education, and my kindergarten teacher was amazing. So I think between that and just my love for education, I knew this was the path I was supposed to be on.
Oh, wow. Awesome. So you went to school, graduated. How was that first year? Like, walking into a kindergarten class, how did that, like, and you're the teacher, you know?
You know, right. So you go through all these years of school where someone's teaching you, telling you what to do, what assignments to turn in. And I remember counting down, like, okay, you know, 3 more days, 2 more days. And then I realized that night before, like, wait a minute, I'm about to be responsible for all these kids. What is that about to look like? So that first day, I was so nervous and saying, like, please let me do what I have to do. But quickly I realized, like, they trust me. Once I saw the parents trusting me and that my job trusted me, I said, okay, now it's time to trust myself. So that first year was so unpredictable. Every day was different. You know, transparency, I did cry a couple times, hoping that I was doing the right thing. But overall, the first year is great once you allow yourself to do what you know that you can do.
So, like, I know there has been so much controversy around the education system, especially, like, in the Black community, just making sure that they have the correct education and people who actually care. Coming from a African-American background, like, how did you use that mindset to kind of, I guess, gear you in your teaching style?
For me, so I have never had a Black teacher until college. So for me, I wanted to, one, show kids that, our kids, that we can be whatever we want. Even if you don't see it, it's a possibility. And then I just used what I've learned, what my mom has taught me, what my Howard professors have taught me to teach my kids, like, in all things, you have full permission to be yourself.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what, when you see my videos, like, the way I talk to adults is the way I talk to kids.
Yes.
It's all the same. So, you know, every now and then it's a little more lighter, like, oh, please do this, please do that. But for the most part, I tell my kids, like, if you have a question, ask it. If
right.
you want to say something, say that. And then especially for my, because I teach majority minorities. So, like, whatever you have to say is worth listening to. My kids know that. I use that. That's what my mom tells me. And that's what I tell them at the same time.
And I noticed that you have created an environment of comfortability with your students to where they literally can come to you about anything. And I love that so much. So before I get to your kids, because I feel like they are their own own entity. <Yeah. laughs>
They are their own little people. Oh my goodness.
They are. And I'm like, I have so many questions. It's so funny. But before we get to that, like the confidence level, was that developed when you were a child?
So for me, truthfully, growing up in San Diego, it's very diverse. We have Black people, we have every other race as well.
Right.
White, Hispanic, Samoan, Asian. So being around so many people that are diverse, it's not a heavy Black population. So for a while, you know, I didn't have that confidence. I didn't see that in myself until I went to Howard. And I'm so grateful for going to Howard because that was when I learned, like, girl, you kind of cool. Like, you got it going on. And everyone should have that moment where they're like, you know what? I got this.
So
it was not something that was always within me. My mom has amazing confidence. She always tells me there's no low self-esteem around here. And she would tell me that. I'm like, girl, I see it in you, but give me a second. So going to Howard definitely shaped that for me. And then seeing my kids have that confidence in me then finally raised it up for myself.
Wow, that's good. That's good that a child can see that, you know?
The thing about teaching the younger kids is that they think I am a genius. Anything I tell them is gold. Anything I give them is powerful. Yeah. And, you know, it could be easy as the ABCs, but, like, I love learning, Ms. Slater. Thank you, Ms. Slater. I'm like, cool. You're welcome, but thank you for listening to me. So I love the younger kids because they fuel me on the days I don't have it for myself.
And that's so good to just find, like, a safe space. And surprising enough that it's a safe space among, like, little kids. I think we don't give children enough credit.
We don't. And I tell people all the time, you're so amazing, you teach them. I said, what y'all don't know is they teach me. Like, I made a TikTok about the life lessons I've learned from them. They have taught me to be unapologetic in all things. Because when you're young, you don't care about that stuff. Like, we learn these things later on in life to be quiet and to do this. But when you're 5 and 6, you make a noise. And they have taught me to make noise and to be okay with that, for sure. Yeah. So I owe that to them 10 times over.
That's good. Honestly, that just, like, stuck with me because I know sometimes, like, it is, you kind of get into this robotic, like, in this box where it's like you have to do it this way and it has to look like this. Like, who says that?
Yes. And sometimes as Black women, we find ourselves, like, I tell myself, you know, trying to tone it down for the comfort of others, this or that. And not in my room, not in my class. We come in. If you want to holler, you holler. Yes. If you're not feeling it, you want to be quiet that day, be quiet that day. So people do not give kids enough credit for the carefree mindset that they have. But I definitely every day do not take that for granted.
That's so amazing. So let's get into these little geniuses. These little geniuses.
Please, let's get into it.
First of all, your little, like, the video reel that you made, I thought it was so adorable. I think I watched it, like, about five times in a row, like, the first time, because I thought it was so
adorable. It just cheers you up, right? It just cheers you up. Yes.
I think my favorite part was the one where the little boy got on one knee and was like, can I ask you a question? Will you marry me?
That man is my pride and joy. He's a first grader now, and his mom, I told her, like, girl, we are blowing up on TikTok. And she said, my baby gonna be a star. I said, girl, possibly. I said, so, you know, I'd never show their faces.
Right.
But she was like, you can show anything you want from him, his face, his YouTube, his this and that. And I said, girl, I said, I'll do my best. But no, he was definitely one of my main teachers to myself of, like, say what you want to say. And there are videos where I didn't post of him because his face is in it.
Yeah.
But one day he told me, like, I'm working hard for this money. I said, you doing what? He said, I'm working hard for my money. I said, me too. And we even clapped like this. He said, appreciate it. I said, all right. I gotta get out of here. So we do not give W enough credit, but that boy in particular was one of my biggest blessings my first year teaching. Like, if I needed to laugh, I was talking to him. I was talking to Dante.
I love that so much. Oh my goodness. And I think it was another one where, like, I'm trying to think. It was So you have so many like that are hilarious.
Yes.
Oh, when I guess you were consoling one of the young man and somebody I guess is trying to be nosy, you was like, bye.
bye. This is our moment, our time. This is our moment, our time. And they are so nosy. Why is he crying? I said, bye. Ask him when he's done, but this is our moment. He's behind, I was like, my desk is my sanctuary. Like, we share everything. Don't come over here unless I ask you to come over here.
I know.
So he, in the video, you can see, but he was starting to walk towards me like, why is he crying? Bye. Turn around. Get to your desk and do that worksheet, baby. Because me and him are having a moment. And all these videos my parents have seen, and the mom was just so grateful. Like, he's a mama's boy, the one who was crying. And I'm a mama's girl. So we had to have our moment. But you, Nosy Rosie, get to where you need to get. No, sir. Not up in here.
I absolutely love that. So, like, what made you start, like, recording these moments? Because it's so amazing. Like, what made you, like, you know what? Let me get...
Right. Like, you know, let me share this. So, initially, yeah. We have, like, our classroom apps. I used something called Blooms last year. And it's like a Facebook, but it's an app for, like, teachers and students.
Okay.
And parents. And so, I would post things like our announcements for the week. And, you know, hey, we're having a Christmas party, things like that. On Fridays, I would just do a quick newsletter or share pictures or whatever from the week. So I started sharing pictures and videos of the kids. Like, hey, guys, this is what it looks like in here. I just want y'all to know your kids are so funny. Let me show you. Yeah. So I had all these videos saved already. And when quarantine hit, I said, you know what? I got on TikTok like everybody did. We all ran to TikTok for the boredom. And I said, let me share these moments. And I didn't expect it to take off, but I'm also not surprised because it just makes you feel good. Like, I wanted to share the moments that make me happy in hopes that other people would be happy as well. And that's exactly what happened. But I had them for our parents, and now they're for everybody, I guess.
So, like, that moment that you realized you went viral, like, how did that feel? Like, how did that happen? Like, walk me through that whole process.
So, literally, I joined TikTok initially to watch the videos because figuring out TikTok was hard. I know Vine. Like, back in the day, we had Vine.
Yep.
You had about 6 seconds, make your video and get off. So,
yep.
TikTok was a whole new world for me.
Yep.
So, I uploaded them, and then I'm like, okay, like, you know, whatever, I'm on to the next thing in quarantine, watching 3,000 Netflix shows, learning new recipes, working out, and I would come back to that video, and the analytics on it were high. I said, 5 million views? Like, what's going on? So, and then for me, what happened after that was I would see the video on different platforms. So, like, BET would post my video, and then BuzzFeed wanted my video, and then E! News wanted my video. And while I am so outgoing, I'm also a very low-key person.
Mm.
So, for me, it was like, oh, my gosh, like, this is cool.
Yeah.
But y'all finna be in my business. Like, I am overwhelmed with joy, but also just overwhelmed, period, because now I have all these people like, thank you, you're so great, you're so this. And I always just feel unworthy because it's like, I would be doing this anyway.
Yeah.
Like, this is just my job, you know? Like, I'm super regular. I'm so chill on this. My friends always be like, oh, here she comes. She famous, y'all. I'm like, y'all, please. Let's just get to the dinner. So while I am grateful, it is very overwhelming for me just because I feel like I'm not worthy. I'm not worthy of any of this because this is just what I would do anyway. Like, whether y'all saw it or not, this is what I would be doing. So I'm grateful, but I'm very overwhelmed that with the support and the love and the reach outs. It's a blessing, but I have some times where I sit down like, girl.
Yeah, but you are worthy of it. That's why he trusted
you. Thank you so much. I appreciate that so much. My mom knows. She's like, Bug. She calls me Bug. She's like, Bug, this is a blessing. Yeah. I'm like, I know, mama, but dang, I can't take it.
Yes. So, like, how has the videos going viral, how has that changed, like, your life right now?
Right. So,
like, have come from that.
I have. So for me, I share nothing. Like, with my job, I've shared nothing. My friends, I'll tell them, but they also follow me, so they see it on their own. Pretty much the only person I share things with is my mother.
Okay.
My homegirl. So what's happening is when things get circulated, people share them and they find them. So my bosses, I never told my bosses, but they called me. Like, is this your E! News? I'm like, it may or may not be. I'm not sure. possibly. And so everyone was excited for me. And so my boss was like, girl, this is so great. We're going to talk about it when we get to school. So while I, when I go to work, like we have our trainings and when we're going through things, I'll say like, okay, someone who went out of the country, read something, read this paragraph, someone who teaches kindergarten. So now they're start being like, someone who's an internet sensation, read the next paragraph. And I'm like, please. Y'all, please. So the opportunities I have gotten from it is advertisements, which I love doing. Like if I can get your brand out there for you and it aligns to what I love, great. I was recently this week, was it this week? No, last week. Time is blurring together in the quarantine. I think it was this week I was on the Three More Show, which was a blessing in itself. I was super humbled to even be asked and sought out. But great opportunities. But I still just say like, either way, y'all, I'm going to hit this classroom and do my job. But
I love it.
And then just me being able to share what I've learned and the tips, the little tips I do have with other future teachers has probably been my favorite part.
Yes. Yes. I was just about to say that, like, I'm pretty sure you have been hit up by so many different educators just for tips and like tidbits of how to even like teach in a classroom, period.
Yes, and it sucks when I tell them, like, y'all, there is no secret besides trust yourself, trust the people that trained you for this, and then more importantly, don't ever try to be someone you're not. Like, don't ever. So, you know, I tell them, like, no, while I appreciate y'all loving my period and all that's how I am.
Yeah.
So I don't want you to go in here like, I'm going to be like Miss Slater or whoever my teacher mentor is, because I, too, have a girl I follow on Instagram before I was teaching that was my teacher mentor. And while I loved everything she did, I knew I couldn't be her.
Right.
So I just tell the teachers that ask me, like, ask questions first and foremost. I blow the school up with questions. I'm asking everybody.
Right.
Like, where's this? How do I do this? But then trust yourself. You did this for 4 years, however many years took you to get the degree.
Yep.
Get to work. And
yep.
Do that. And know that that's, they're, the kids trust you. So you have to show that to them that you trust yourself.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So I'm going to actually say like a little line to insert, like, cause I do want them to see some of your videos. Okay.
Yes, of course.
So I know you guys are probably wanting to know like these videos, like we're talking about of her little geniuses that she, that she teaches. So check these out and we'll be right back.
So we're making a prediction, a prediction is a guess. So you want to know what I think he wished for?
What?
I think he wished that Amy is going to be his girlfriend.
Yeah!
Hand him the talking stick back. Dante, what do you want to be when you grow up?
A lover and a dancer.
A lover and a dancer. Excellent. Love that. What you need to ask me?
Will you marry me?
Yeah.
I am
Slater. And what's at the end of my sentence?
Period.
Everyone say period.
Period.
Do the hand. Period.
Period.
Period. A period stops. A sentence.
Walking. What did you do?
The period says period poo, like
no.
This. Yeah. Period poo, love it. All right, great.
Okay, but I do want to ask you, with all the craziness that's been going on with quarantine and forcing us to be out of work and being able to basically touch people, like how has this affected your job? Because I mean, you are so hands-on with your students.
I am so hands-on, and same thing I said on the Drew Barrymore show, I want to love them, hug them, see them, high-five them. Kindergarten is hands-on learning, but it's also hands-on when you build those relationships. As you saw, like, we are hugging, we are high-fiving, we are proposing, like, we are so person. And so for me, initially, like, now that I am teaching virtually, I do get to teach from my classroom, which gives me a sense of normalcy, at least I'm in the space that I normally am, but to be in the camera all day, initially, I lost my motivation. Like those first couple of weeks, I was like, this is not it. And I wouldn't show that to them, but as soon as the camera, you know, say bye, I would sit back like, I can't do this. And so I've had to tell myself, like, this is what we have. Like, this is all we have. So use that to the best of your ability. So now I just have to give them everything. I have energy, but I've never had energy like this before. Mm-hmm. Because I still want them to feel like Miss Slater loves me. She cares about me. And I don't want what's happening in the world to affect the relationships that we have. Like, I'm still your teacher. even though I can't do what I would normally do. But I've definitely had to give myself pep talks more than ever before. Like, girl, this is your situation, so make the best of it. And don't let the kids suffer because you don't like it. And then while it's a safer option, it's not the ideal option for kindergarten.
Absolutely. And that's a good point. Just because you're suffering, like, don't make them suffer. They'll never know.
That's
a lifelong lesson, you know? Like, just because you're going through, like, if you're giving yourself to other people and people are waiting for you and expectation from you, like, they don't deserve to feel what you're going through.
They don't deserve my crankiness. They don't deserve my pouting. And so we do something in our morning meeting called an emotional check-in. And every morning we say, this morning I feel blank because blank. So, you know, I got to push them to use them full sentences because in the beginning they're like happy. I'm like, tell me this morning I feel blank because blank. Yes. And I'll tell them, I said, you know, sometimes, you know, this morning I feel sad because I'm in my classroom alone. And I will tell them that. And I tell them, like, you know, whatever emotion you feel is valid. And I try to show that, like, every day Ms. Slater is not happy, but I'm happy to be with you. And I try to just keep that in my mind, like, everything else might suck. I have a million and one emails. Yeah. I have administration giving me new things to do. Actually, last week, I just got moved out of my classroom. So, like, all those things going on, but you are not the reason why it's happening. And so I can't show that to you. So we're going to do this brain break. We're going to get our wiggle out. We're going to laugh up in here. But as soon as the camera cuts off, then I'm going to feel the emotions that I have.
Yeah. So, are you guys going to be able to get back into the classroom this year at all?
So as of last week, which is why I have been going through it this week, we found out on Monday we were going back to school in person. However, I will not. So everyone, parents had a choice to pick in person, hybrid, or virtual. So that means someone has to be assigned to do the virtual. Because I am so crazy, because I am on level 10 all the time, I got assigned to be the virtual teacher because I have the most energy of my team. So on Monday, my team will have kids in person. They're decorating their doors and their bulletin boards, and I will not. So this week has been so hard for me. Oh my God, I'm trying not to cry.
I know. I felt it just now.
It's been so hard for me, like, not having that.
Yeah.
And so I have to just keep that energy and know that this is the path that I'm on, but it's for a reason. So Monday, I will see the kids. I have 26 kids. I've lost 18 of them because they picked to be in person or hybrid. Yeah. So I've lost my class. I have new kids from their class coming in, but Monday is going to be hard. Like, walking down that hallway and seeing their doors and seeing their little backpacks. And then I go to my new designated area, because they have to use my classroom for social distancing, to my little new area that I have, but it's not my kids' fault. Like, it's not their fault. So Monday I will be the same energy I have, but, like, oh, I want to see them kids. I know.
And just, like, now, is it going to be any possible way, like, you're going to be back in the classroom with your kids?
So as of what my district has told me, I will probably be virtual up until this whole semester. So, like, this is what we're sticking to for the rest of the semester. In January, based upon how the virus looks, we could go back to fully everyone being in person, but I know I will be virtual for sure until January. And I have a lot of parents messaging me, like, she wants to go to school. We want to go to school with you. Like, we don't want a new teacher. And I'm like, I love that so much. But this is what we have, and I will pop my head in if I can, but, like, please still text me, email me, call me if you need me. I have no problem helping, but until January at least, I will still be virtual.
Although this year looks different, like, my pastor, he said something so vital, and it really helped me, like, through this year and through this whole, like, pandemic. He was just like, even though we might be quarantined, God has us contained.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just like, wow, like, that is so good, like, to look at it almost as a protection of and not a protection of coronavirus, of course, that's included, but, like, a protection of our gifts. You're creating new ways, like, innovativeness, like, just inventions, witty ideas, like, that you're going to, like, be able to expound on. So next year, like, just imagine all, like, everything that you're learning this year, next year, when you got, when you're actually back in the classroom, oh, please.
It's I'm about to be untouchable. I'm going to be untouchable. Like, me and my mom always say that when I have my hard day. She's like, girl, this is building your toolbox, your resume. Like, there are things that we have never tried before that we have to think and do. And I, in that reason between the kids and this reason of like, this is just teaching you something different is what keeps me going. Like, I have become a Zoom master. I didn't even know you could annotate on Zoom. I didn't even know you could do breakout rooms on Zoom. Like, it's just something more that we can use. And you are so correct. Like, he has us covered completely in my career, which I'm grateful to still have in the midst of a pandemic. Like, when I do get my staff meetings, I'm like, girl, you still paying your rent. Like, it's going to be okay. Hello. And my mom still has a job. My friends still have their jobs. Like, it's so much bigger than me. Like, the people that I care about are still covered. My dad was furloughed for a little bit, and even they have finally got back on track. So, like, everyone that is in my main corner is covered. I am covered. My kids are still learning. We're going to be okay. So I will cry a little bit. As you see, I'm a crier. I will cry.
Girl, listen here. I'm a waterhead.
One thing about me, I'm going to cry. I'm going to cry. But I'm going to wipe it off. And I'm going to know that I'm covered and he has me every time.
Yes, exactly right. And I even think about even like bigger than the classroom. Like, I can see them even asking you to teach a TED Talk of teachers. Just look, you know,
If they call me, I'm ready. I'm ready. Get my stage on.
Okay. I'm ready. Like TED Talk teach, you know, and like literally like pouring out information among other teachers, you know, with them with notepads and you teaching them, learning from you, you know?
Literally. And I have learned that while I think I'm doing nothing, it's helping somebody. Like the thing, you know, I don't think twice about it. I wake up, I go to work, I talk to my kids, I leave. It's nothing to me, but for people to have this faith in me and to be inspired by what I'm doing. Is showing me like, okay, girl, you got a gift and your gift just so happens to be what funds your life, which is great, you know, but like help others and get them on track. I forget what it felt like to be a first year teacher and to have so many questions, so many concerns. And I had to step back and realize like, okay, girl, July 2019, you were stressing and other people want to know what's going on, especially in virtual.
I mean,
that's why I feel so silly post my little YouTube videos like, hey guys, but like, people text me like, or message me like, thank you for this. It helped me. So I'm going to keep doing that. So if a TED Talk is next, I'm ready.
Okay. Listen, I'm going to be rooting you on because I want to get on TED Talk too. So listen here. I believe in connection. So look.
You are an excellent interviewer. Like, it feels just like a conversation, like super comfortable. So they need to get on TED Talk as well. Yes. I'm seizing the day for sure. They need that.
I love it. And so like, I just like want to tell you before we leave that like this is just the beginning. Can you imagine, like, for one, this year is somebody's first year teaching.
My whole team, I have a team of, it's a four of us. I have taught before. The other three have never taught before.
Wow.
And so I told them, I said, you guys, give me a second because I haven't been my usual chipper self because I'm going through some things. I'm sad about it. I said, but Monday is still your first day of school and first day of teaching. Yes. I said, so I want y'all to wear the cute outfits. I want y'all to be happy. I want y'all to do all that. So if you need me, let me know. But just give me a second to process. So this crazy year is some people's first year. And it started through a computer screen. I'm grateful that my first year wasn't. And I have to be grateful for that last year that I had, which was normal. For sure. So
next year is going to be a like shell shock. Like next year for a lot of teachers, they're going to be like, wait a minute.
Like, hello, because Monday only kindergarten is coming back. Our school is K through five. So Monday is just kindergarten and pre-K. And then the next week we're slowly rolling in the other grades. But it's they're not going to see the magnitude of all these little bodies with their mask on. It's so weird. I can't even imagine a five-year-old with their mask on. Like, knowing my kids from last year who are now first graders with a mask on, please, someone else is going to be wearing someone else's mask. I guarantee you within the hour, like within the hour, someone is going to have someone else's mask on. Like, oh man. I'm praying
about that too. I seen a meme about that.
Girl, I posted one yesterday. It said, kindergartners, when you tell them to social distance for the 4 millionth time, their eyeballs were touching. Like, literally eyeball to eyeball. We just be on each other. Like, I'm used to it. I'm used to a kid being in my face. I'm not an adult, but I'd be like, you have so much patience. I said, for children. I'm used to a kid being close to me.
Yeah.
And asking them silly, like, can I have a pencil? Like, back up, bro. Please. So Monday's going to be interesting. Social distancing in kindergarten doesn't mix, but we're going to have to make it mix.
Yeah. Oh, man. Just the creativity that has to be involved now.
They're going to have face shields. I think they're buying us scrubs just in case. Like,
wow.
Yes, it is so different. But this is a story that we can tell our children years later. Like, let me tell you about 2020.
You know what the crazy part is that I just find astonishing is how I would say from 2010 to now, like this generation of kids, they are so locked into their rooms on like virtual everything. And it's either going to do one or two things. It's going to almost bring back like a nostalgia feeling like next year, like everybody wants to be around everybody, you know, back in the day, always outside playing, you know, or either it's going to make it worse. And of course, I only pray for it that we can have that bit of nostalgia where everybody's outside playing, you know, being around.
Yes, get outside. I was an outside girl. You know, your mama tell you like, you smell like outside. These kids will be smelling like outside. And that's the problem.
Let me tell you. I remember my mom kicking me out the house at 9 o'clock in the morning and don't come back until around 4. You could check in around 12.
And I'll be having a little snack, but go outside.
Let me tell you, I remember even playing hard outside, trying to come in and get a glass of water, and she's like drinking the water hose.
Literally, I am out here playing like it's my job. I had a little scooter. I had a little Barbie Jeep. Baby, I was outside. You knocking on someone's house, someone's door like, can so-and-so come out to play?
That's it.
And my thing is that these kids are either going to be so technology savvy or my mom said, they're going to be weird. They're going to be weird.
Socially awkward. Because
we don't have those social skills.
Yes, exactly. And it's so really
I'm praying for, like you said, either just a benefit and not them struggling and not knowing the nostalgia of being outside. But
I mean,
Ivy wanted to see
more. Necessary.
Like, yes, it's necessary.
Oof.
Ooh, please. Literally, please go outside. Go play outside. You know, you get so outside, you're sweaty. Hair don't look the same when you left.
Exactly.
Clothes dirty. I want that for them.
I need all of that.
All that.
But like I said, I just want to tell you that you are, this is just the beginning. And like God has placed a special gift like on you and in you that is going to affect the multitude and affect them in a positive way, you know. So just get ready, hold on to your seat, and enjoy the ride, you know.
Man, okay, I am like I said, I'm overwhelmed, but it's a good overwhelmed. Yeah. I am grateful that I get to show people what I love to do. I'm grateful that I get to talk to amazing people like you about what I do. And I'm just very optimistic that this opportunity will not just benefit me, but my future students, my past students, and then my family as well.
Yeah. Yes. Oh, well, Simone, I don't want to like stop right now. It's like,
literally we're kikiing. I feel like I know you forever, but I feel like we have brunch.
I know, right? Like where my mimosa at?
Literally, where is it? Because we're talking, we're laughing. Yes.
So much. We definitely have to do this again. Because like I said, I know like this is just the beginning for you. So as soon as you get that notice of TED Talk, I'm like, let's do an interview.
We manifested. So let me hop on. And next time I'm bringing my beverage because we got to talk then.
Yes, ma'am. I mean, who knows where this can lead. Listen here, we'll cross paths sometime. And like, 2021, 2022, hopefully.
Okay,
and
we made it. We made it.
We made it out. I love it. Well, we always say this saying before we leave, you know, before I end the show, tomorrow is never promised. So make sure you get out and seize the day. And I am a stickler for that because this year alone has shown you that tomorrow is not promised. We have lost so many amazing people this year, like that has caught us by surprise.
Like beyond the idea of us having to stay in the house, it was from the beginning of January, from Kobe to this, like literally January has been a year. I told my best friend, I said, my birthday's in January. I said, so January we teed up for my birthday. After that, it all went downhill. Like, and it's teaching me to live.
Yeah.
Like to truly, truly live. I love to be in the house and I'm such a like, I'm in I'm an ambivert. Like, I'm extrovert and introvert. So I'll talk to you, but I do have days where I'm like, no. This has taught me to live. Call the people that are on your mind.
Yeah.
Text them. Hang out with them. Like, we have to live. Like, we have to seize the day, girl. Yes. We have to seize the day.
We have to. Yes. If I didn't know the purpose of this show before, like, I started this show last year in April, my birthday. And if I did not know the importance of, like, what I was naming my show and what my show was about, like, oh, I have learned it this year. I have learned it this year. I have been so purposeful, and I have been, like, intentional, like, with everything that I've been doing with this show. Like, you have to.
I'd be smiling in the grocery store now because I'm here. Like, going through Trader Joe's, like, good morning. because that, you quickly see that life, like you said, tomorrow is not promised. And you can say that, like, yeah, it's not, but it's truly not.
Yes.
We've lost so many people due to the virus, due to their own life struggles. Like, girl, I'm going to call my mama after this because we're talking about it. Like,
listen.
What? Me and my mom used to call each other morning, noon, and night. I'm squeezing in conversations in between, like, hey, girl, it's me again.
I know.
You have to.
Yep, exactly right. And, I mean, like, I have older parents, so that's one of the things that I have to really, like, make sure that I constantly check on them. Like, I'm always around them. I always want to see them. I always want to, like, hear their voice. Like, there's sometimes I'm just, like, sitting at work. I'm like, I miss my mommy. You know, I miss my mommy. Let me call them.
That's the kindergartner's bond. Like, I miss my mommy. I'm like, hand me a tissue, because me too.
Okay.
me too. My mom said she's coming next month, and I am counting down to show her, like, Dallas and all things I've done. Like, I love my mama.
I know.
Wholeheartedly, forwards, backwards, round and round. I love my daddy. Like, yes.
Yes. Like, me and my parents, we call ourselves the Three Musketeers. And it's because it's just us three, you know?
Yes. It is me. So it is me. My parents are divorced, but they're friends.
Oh,
so,
good.
Like, we're all cool, but I grew up with just me and my mom.
Yeah.
So, like, when I tell you, and I have no siblings or nothing. So, when I tell you, that is my homegirl.
Okay.
That is my homegirl. She said, as soon
only
as I
child power, to- only child power. Hello.
She said, isn't it a blessing?
Yes.
She said, as soon as I get married in Dallas, she's moving here. Like, she's just waiting for the right man. She said, as soon as you get married, I'm coming out there.
Because
I need to see what y'all doing. I said, girl, come on. Come on.
Listen here. Okay. And whenever you find him, send his friend my way because
because the quarantine is taking up my 20s. I'm not gonna be this youngest fry forever. I need to find him.
Listen here. My little click is just a ticking. Look.
It wasn't before, but for some reason I feel like I'm running out of time because the quarantine.
I'm 31. I just turned 31 this year, and I'm just like,
I'm literally in Target, like, can you pull your mouse down for just a second? I just need to see if I need to shoot my shot. I've never shot my shot before, but now I feel like I have no time.
Yeah.
So I'm like, hey, how you doing?
Listen, and look, your followers is up there, so you got a little, your ocean is a little bit more bigger now. Look, I'm trying to get up
right now. See, now, y'all would think that. My friend said that too, like, I know your man in there. No, baby, what's in there is future teachers. And the rainbow lanyard that I wear, our school had a training for LGBTQ children, and we wear them to show that we are a safe space.
Yeah, yeah.
Accepting, I'm an ally. What's happening right now is it's future teachers and women. And so because of the rainbow lanyard, so I'm like, hey, I appreciate you. I'm an ally. I love you. However, I'm looking for my black team. Please. I'm looking for my black clean, y'all. I'm sorry. So y'all would think the DMs is packed, but it's not doing that. So I'm still out here in Target searching. Like,
now, I do know and maybe we can talk about this offline. I do know.
Girl, look, I forgot we were interviewing. At this point, we just keeking. I forgot.
Okay,
I forgot we were recording.
I'll just cut this part out. But
look, I love me some day, girl. I'm sorry. You done messed up now. We friends now. Messed up, day.
Okay, hello.
You done messed up, girl. We friends now. It's too late.
I do know an educator friend who had, like, about the same amount of followings as you.
Oh, well, Kiki. Oh, yes.
Very nice looking.
Okay. Oh, yeah. We're going to do this. See, I don't know if I follow you back because I can't see when people follow me on Instagram or whatever.
Yeah.
But after this is done, we're going to email and talk. We are.
I got you.
Where are you located? We better be friends. I'm not playing.
Yes, I'm down. Look, North Carolina, girl. I'm in Raleigh.
Excellent. You're not far. It's no problem. We're going to be friends.
Here. I will hop on a plane in a heartbeat. Listen.
And me as well. Safety with my mask on, but I'm coming. Okay.
I love it. Listen here. Girl, yes. Oh, this is so dope. I love this type of stuff.
You started my Saturday off so good. Oh, and I appreciate that so much. Thank you so much. Thank you for being scheduled with me as well. I appreciate that. I know it's last minute, but I'm so glad we got to do this.
This is what, honestly, this type of stuff is what matters. So, like, I would have pushed everything back to make sure we had this moment. Like, I'm fine.
Oh, thank you. Man, thank you. I'm going to have a good day. I love when I started off right. And this is definitely that.
You are.
I love beautiful Black women coming together, girl. It hypes me up.
Hello. Listen here. It's a seat for all of us at the table.
It's a long table. People don't realize. It's a long table. We got time and we got room.
And we have room to add tables on. Like,
I hate when people think that, you know, you doing your thing is hindering someone else from doing theirs. Like, we all have our different gifts, our different niches. Like, there's room. There's certainly room.
So much room. So much room. Oh, my gosh. I love this so much.
Girl, I'm literally smiling. We hang up like this. Right. Nice person.
Exactly. So let me go ahead and end this out so we can, like, Kiki on that back end.
Yes, yes, yes.
You guys, it has been such an amazing, amazing opportunity to interview Miss Simone Slater. Simone, let them know where they can find you, all of your handles.
Okay, y'all. So you can follow me on Instagram at _lovesimone or on TikTok at @lovemissslater. Thank you for this so much day. It has been a pleasure and honor. And y'all are so blessed to be watching her because this is an amazing woman. I've quickly learned in this conversation. So thank you so much for having me.
Thank you so much. You guys know what I always say, tomorrow is not promised. So make sure you get out and seize the day.
Seize the day. I love that.